Hello everyone, hope all of you are fine and safe. This is Lopa Mudra Dev once again with another video. This time I become little late to upload the video, so I am really apologize for that. So let's start the session. As usually today also I will start the session. Today's is not a quotation, it's a suggestion by our former president Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam to all the educationists. Being the members of this fraternity, we must take the suggestion so that we can really uplift the society. He suggested educationists should build the capacities of the spirit of inquiry, creativity, entrepreneurial and moral leadership among the students and become their role model. Actually, being the educators or being teachers, mostly we emphasize on bookish knowledge, providing bookish knowledge to the children. That's why they become very, very dependent on others. They do not develop their sense of creativity, then innovations, then invention, such kind of things are not happening nowadays. Earlier, most of the scientists, mathematicians, doctors, like from the ancient era, were from our country. But nowadays, inclination towards bookish knowledge, making the children or the future citizen of the country little bit theoretical, and they are lacking in practical knowledge. They are depend more on themselves. Self dependency is nowadays very much lacking. Self confidence is lacking. That's why our children are gradually lacking in their self esteem. So to make them to grow the self esteem in the children, we must provide them the environment or opportunity so that they can build the capacities of inquiry, innovation, invention, creativity, and also moral senses that will really make them successful in their real life. And being teacher, we must follow the same so that they can, like while discussing about idealist, they completely believe that students, they whatever they learn by learn from the influence of the teachers. So teachers must become their role model. Teachers must follow all those things. Then only we can expect the children or the future citizen of the country to acquire such abilities or capacities. Okay, today I will discuss a topic from environmental education. In one of my previous videos, I discussed about environmental ethics, because it's my personal opinion that until and unless we get to know about environmental ethics and we do not take oath to be ethical towards the environment, there will be no use of learning about environmental education. Okay, so today's video, it's not about exactly about environmental education. First, let us know what actually environment is. What is the meaning of environment? Then only we will understand about, we will be prepared to know about environmental education, and we will get to know how environmental, how we can educate the children regarding environmental issues. Okay, let's know about environment first. I think those who nowadays environmental education is there in almost all the disciplines, because the environment is at the verge of destruction. We are continuously exploiting the environmental resources. Now it's become very, very essential for everyone to understand the basic concept of environment, its nature, its characteristics, and its structure. Then only we will realize that how important environment is for all of us. So those who are from science background, or I can expect those who are not also, this much you know about environment because you have learned in the school days also, that environment is derived from a French word, that is environ-near, that is double N, environ-near. And the meaning of this particular word is the surrounds, or you can say encircle also, to encircle or to surround. That means whatever that is there surrounding, in our surroundings, everything can be said as our environment. Whatever, no matter whether it is a biological thing. Biological means something that is bio, the word of the meaning bio is life. So whenever it is said biological, that means we are talking about something living. And also non-biological things, that is those who are non-living. Okay, so everything around us, no matter whether it is a living creature or non-living things, everything in totality is called as, in is means as environment. Okay, so here that is to make the meaning clearly. I have written, it's not a definition actually, you can say this is the meaning of environment. It is the sum total of the surrounding of a living organism, including natural forces and other living things, which provide conditions for development and growth, as well as of danger and damage. Okay, suppose we can take three questions into consideration. If we ask three questions and answer the questions, it will be clear to us what environment actually is. Suppose the question is, what is surrounded? I said that the meaning of the word environer, from where the word environment has derived, is surround. Now let me ask the question, what is surround? Okay, kaun surrounded hai? If we take the example of human beings, suppose the answer is human being or a man is surrounded. Okay, then next question will come, that by what it is surrounded, that means what are the things that are surrounded by that surround the human being. What are the things, by what things human is surrounded, humans are surrounded. Suppose now the answer will be the air, which is the non-biological component. Then the soil, which is another non-biological component and are very, very essential for survival of human beings. Then water and also the living organisms. It may be microorganisms, those who are so minute that cannot be seen with the naked eyes. They can be other big living creatures like kettles are there, plants are there, big trees, very small sharp shrubs, then herbs. So many kind of living creatures are there surrounding the human beings. And where it is surrounded, where means then we need to talk about habitat. Okay, when the question is what, then the answer is the man. Then if the question is by what, then the answer will be the biological and non-biological components. And when the question will be asked that where it is surrounded, the answer of the question where, then it will be the habitat or resident. Okay, that means that particular place where an individual live in. Okay, so these three questions, answer of these three questions can lead us to explain or understand the meaning of environment very, very clearly. At the same time, these are whatever things that surround us, we must understand the fact that these conditions provide conditions for development and growth. That means they have influence us. They have influence on us. It can be physical influence, it can be psychological influence. That means they have influence, direct influence on us. Normally, what we think that we influence our environment. We are the constructionists of the environment, but it is not actually true. Both the surrounding of an individual and the individual itself have equal influence on each other. The way we influence them, the same way they also have equal influence on us. And they help. If the influence is positive, then it will cause growth and development. Positive, that is growth and development. And if the influence is negative, then it will cause damage and danger. Like so many natural calamities, so many hazards that ultimately cause various severe damages and dangers. So that's how both positive and negative influence individual are having due to environment. Okay, so whatever damage and danger we have talked about, it's not always natural calamities or environmental hazards. It can be malnutrition of an individual. It can be antisocial behavior of an individual. It can be ill adjustment behavior of an individual. So all such things, psychological and physical influence, all are influences. All such things has influence on living organism, or we can say the human who is there in the center. And the human activity also has equal influence on the environment, or you can say the surrounding. the way the surrounding influence us, same way we also have equal influence on it. Our activities, like if we, a simple example, let us talk about, like during the lockdown days, when there were no vehicles on the road, that created a positive influence on the environment. The air has become very, very clean. The water bodies became clean. The pollen content of the air becomes so less. The place like Delhi, who is known for its abnormal, that is polluted air pollution rate, that particular place has also become pollution free during the lockdown days, and that is an impact of ours. We, most of the people, human beings, they did not go out of the houses, they did not drive any car, there were no traffic jam, so many things were there. So that was our influence, due to which the environment became clean. Again, due to continuous destruction of forests, or you can say the just opposite situation, when in normal days, when so much of cars are run by the residents of Delhi, the peoples of Delhi, which causes too much of air pollution, though not only the vehicle, but also so many contributing factors are there. Vehicle is just a contributing factor, so many other main factors are there, and in such case, that activity of human being again cause damage to the environment. So environment also has positive or negative influence on us, and we also influence the surrounding or the environment positively or negatively. Okay, so that is the actual meaning of environment. Environment, you can say, the sum total of the conditions which is surround a man at a given point of space and time. Suppose when a child is in the morning, a child is in the school, so the school campus will be the environment. At that time, the influence of the teachers, the impact of the knowledge that they are getting in the schools, the school environment, everything will have influence on the child, and the child will also have equal influence on the school environment. And when the child will return back to home after completion of the school timing, the home and will be the his environment, the family members, the parents, the whatever they are at home, everything will be his environment, his or her environment. That's how environment, you cannot say that I am living in Guwahati, so this is the only environment of mine. If you go to Delhi, the condition of Delhi will be the environment. So it refers to the time and space. Okay, so in which an individual is living, okay, an individual is residing, so that will be the environment of that particular human. Okay, so this is the meaning of the environment. I hope you have understood the meaning. If you are liking the video, please hit the like button and share to those who will get benefited from it. And to encourage my effort, don't forget to like it and do comment if any kind of change is required. Okay, so hope you have understood the meaning of environment. Let me speak in tell you in Hindi also. Environment jo hai parivesh, wo total, sum total, jo bhi cheeze hamare charo taraf hai, वो जैविक हो अजैविक हो एनीथिंग, एंड इस जैविक अजैविक चीजों का हमारे ऊपर जो इन्फ्लुएंस होता है और हमारा जो इनके ऊपर इन्फ्लुएंस होता है, ये जो टोटल इंटरेक्शन विच हैज बोथ पॉजिटिव एंड निगेटिव इम्पैक्ट, दैट इज अबाउट ऑल अबाउट एनवायरनमेंट. ओके, सो होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड इट. लेट्स प्रोसीड टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. Now, some definitions that I feel very, very easy, and it is very, you can memorize it clearly. And those who are from another medium, जो English medium के नहीं है, जो हिंदी और किसी दूसरे भाषा में exam देंगे, उनके लिए भी ये बहुत beneficial होगा, क्योंकि this particular definitions as quotations can be used by any students from any medium. ये नहीं है कि आप लोगों को ये translate करना पड़ेगा किसी दूसरे भाषा में. आप जिस भाषा में भी exam दे रहे हो, you can directly use these quotations while during your exams. And जो मैंने feel किया है, these are some selected definitions. There are so many ample number of definitions given by number of environmentalists, but I have selected a few which are very easy to memorize. Okay, so first Anastasi, he said that the environment is everything that affects the individual except the genes. Okay, अगर आप लोगों ने growth and development का जो principles और characteristics है वो पढ़ा है, then you will understand that there are two factors that influence the growth and development of an individual, which are heredity and environment. So heredity is directly related to the gene, that is the DNA we have got from our ancestors, okay, our parents or our forefathers or ancestors. Okay, so some of our characteristics, हमारे कुछ कुछ जो characteristics है वो environment से कम influence होते हैं, that are directly influenced by the genetic character that has transferred from our parents to us in the form of DNA. Okay, so environment का जो impact है according to Anastasi, whenever we are talking about environment, we are talking about everything that surrounds us and everything that has impact on us, that affects the individual except the genes. Though there are so many theories that explains that gradually genetic change also take place due to environment, so let us not talk about all those things. Here a nice explanation is given where Anastasi has separated the impact of heredity from environment in the life of an individual. Okay, then P. Gilbert, he said environment is anything immediately surrounding an object and exerting a direct influence on it. Just now, whatever we were discussing. Suppose a child is growing in a environment where जहाँ कि उसको the parents are not very literate, the parents they are very much ignorant about the ways to behave with the child. They are uncultured. They do not know exactly about the a proper method of nutrition, education should be provided to the child. So in such case, what will happen? We cannot expect the child to be very social, very healthy, intellectually. Though intellectual nature, it's normally comes from the hereditary factor to the children, still some environment should be provided to nourish that particular hereditary character. So if such kind of things are not there in the immediate surrounding, in that case we cannot expect something very superior individual from that environment. So it shows that our immediate environment has direct influence on us. Okay, so on the other hand, a child is growing in a very well cultured family, very well to do family. So in that case, we can expect a superior individual from that particular family. So that is that's all about said by P. Gisbert. Now Boring, he said, a person's environment consists of sum total of the stimulation which he receives from his conception until his death. So I think you know about internal and external environment. Environment can be again divided. Internal and external environment. If we take man into consideration, just now in the previous slide, we discussed about three questions, that an answer of those three questions can give a clear picture of environment of an individual. So suppose if we are talking about a man, a person, an individual, a human being, in that case, internal environment will be his or her mother's womb. That means from the date of conception, till birth. After birth, when the individual will come out from the mother's womb and will introduce him or herself to the environment that is outside mother's womb will be called as external environment. So whenever we talk about environment, we cannot talk about the physical things that we see around us. Okay. We need to consider the actual birth of an individual, from the date of conception, whatever environment, whatever influences the child, unborn baby has faced in the mother's womb will also be taken into consideration. That means it should be not from birth till death, but from conception until the death of the individual. Maa ke om se leke death tak ka jo safar hai, jo bhi influence surroundings ka hai, sabko totality mein hum environment keh sakte hai. Now Wood Oath has given another very very interesting and easy definition. He said that environment covers all the outside factors that has acted on individual since he began life. So both the ye do definition, jo Wood Oath aur Boring, in dono ka definition ek dusre ko complement karta hai. Yaha Boring also said about internal environment, that means from birth, from conception, that means the beginning of life, when mother conceives, then the beginning, the formation of zygote in the mother's womb is the beginning of the life of an individual, and then till 9 months he or she needs to be inside the mother's womb. So that environment should also be taken into consideration, because that environment also has influence on us. I think aap logon ne महाभारत का कहानी सुना है, जहाँ अर्जुन का पुत्र जो है उनको जो चक्रव्यूह का जो रास्ता मालूम हुआ वो मदर के ओम्ब में ही हुआ था. एंड दैट इज दैट प्रूव्स दैट सो मेनी थिंग्स चिल्ड्रेन लर्न व्हेन दे आर इनसाइड द मदर्स ओम्ब. So that environment also be taken into consideration. Okay. Now, according to E.J. Ross, he said environment is an external force which influence us. Okay. As we said that both we and environment, we have equal, like I think you know about physics law, like every action has equal, Newton's law of motion, third law of motion, every action has equal and opposite reaction. Same way action and reaction, you can compare with that of the human being with its surrounding or the environment. The way environment act on us, we same way we react, and the way we react on the environment, environment also has reaction on us. Okay, both of us, we influence each other. Okay, so this all about the definition of environment. You can choose the easy definition. So many definitions you will get in the books. Like while discussing today's video, so the pictures that I have just now discussed, shown while discussing the meaning of environment, that picture I have collected from the book called Perspectives of in Environmental Studies by Anubhava Kaushik and C.P. Kaushik. That is a good book. I can prescribe you the book for environmental education paper. Okay, now, okay, the video has got very long, so it's time to say you goodbye. Please, structure portion I have not discussed, I could not discuss here in this video. To know about the structure of environment, you will have to see the next video, which will be uploaded soon. So, I forgot to wish you all a Happy New Year. Wish you all a very, very happy and safe and prosperous new year. Whatever adversities we faced this time, I wish no one should face the same in this new year also. Though so many positive things also there, we could spend more time with our families and friends. We could spend time on gathering knowledge, but still wish a more enjoyable new year. Have a great year. Bye bye.